hard for a lot of us civilians, frankly, to kind of put our heads around this term implosion. So let's start by talking about the conditions that would be found down there on the ocean floor 2.5 miles down that could lead to such an event.
Well, John, the conditions are, I mean, it's very deep. It's very cold. It's a very unforgiving environment, extreme pressure acting on the submersible. Of course, it's a one atmosphere submersible, so the people inside don't feel that pressure. But a failure like that is extremely unfortunate. And my thoughts and prayers go out to the families and just a very unfortunate accident. Yeah.
So we know this was about a little over 12,600 feet below the surface. It's in a very remote area, 900 miles east of Cape Cod, about 400 miles or so south of St. John's, Newfoundland. Talk about how remote this area is in the North Atlantic. It's pretty far away from just about anything, right?
It's pretty far away. I've been all over the world and whether we're in a submarine or on a surface vessel, you don't get the feel of how large the earth is and how remote you are till you get out to one of those locations. So, but again, amazing effort by the search and rescue and everybody mobilizing to get out there in such short order, because it's out there, it's remote. If you didn't bring it with you, you don't have it and you don't get it. So, I mean, it's a pretty challenging environment to operate in.
And Bob, we talked a little bit about this company from Wellfleet on the Cape that manufactured and operates one of those remote operated vehicles that actually found this debris field. We know you're not connected with this search, but based on your experience, what's likely to happen now? I mean, they'll map this debris field. There's likely, probably not much to recover. Is it your sense they'll leave kind of what's there, leave well enough alone at this point?
You know, John, you're absolutely right. They'll go out and they'll accurately map the debris field in and around off the bow of the Titanic where they located that. And then I think they'll probably consult with other authorities, with the families, and see what they can learn or what they need to recover, if anything. Me personally, as tragic as it is, I think it's a great opportunity to learn from what occurred so we can better design our submersibles or figure out what the root cause was. So, we can better explore those depths, with a good confidence that we can go down, learn, and come back, with the information we get.
All right, Bob Ashton, we thank you for your time and your service. We appreciate it.